And one of the ways to recognize where that key level of support and resistance is by looking at the volume by price. So normally you'd be looking at volume of shares in terms of how many shares were traded on that given period. And normally it's plotted below at the bottom of the chart. Volume by price is different. Volume by price is going to give you the volume at any given price. The more volume at a given price, the more important that level is for us as market participants trying to recognize where support is, where resistance is, and where that polarity is going to come into play in the future. So here we are looking at shares of Home Depot throughout 2015 and 2016. And here you could very easily see this 111, 113 level. There was a ton of volume taking place. So of course, that former resistance turns into support in the future. So now that when we have new resistance, we can see that the most volume in Home Depot took place right around this 135, 137 level. And you can see this by the volume by price. But let's say we just took this completely out of the way. We can just recognize there was a ton of churning here. We can recognize there was a ton of churning here. We can do that without necessarily using the volume by price. So if you're new to charting, you're new to looking for polarity, support and resistance levels, by all means, use the volume by price indicator. I think it's great. After you start looking at enough charts, if you look at as many charts as I do, it's really not necessary, and you can kind of just eyeball it, and without the volume by price, you know the volume took place here. Former resistance turned into support. You know plenty of volume took place near this 135 level, so you can just eye it. So for newbies, definitely get the volume by price. Most charting softwares allow you to do that. Once you looked at enough charts, I think you can figure it out on your own.